Hey everyone, it is Josh here with HostGator. Today we are excited to show you how to build a new WordPress website from the ground up. In this series, we'll help you take your website from looking like this to looking like this in just a few easy steps. Today, we're going back to our theme to cover a couple more sections in depth, and we're actually going to start building out our homepage with more blocks. As always, if you need to get caught up in this series, I put links to the videos in the description below, but if you're ready to go, let's get started. In our last video, we got our widgets and top-level navigation menu set up, so today we're going to focus on building out our homepage. Let's navigate back to our pages section in the dashboard so we can take a look at what our front of site looks like. We'll hover over pages here and click on all pages. This takes us directly to the pages dashboard. Now that we're here, we're looking for the page marked hyphen front page, which is going to tell us the first page of the site that visitors will see as soon as they access our website. If you remember back to our earlier video in the customizer, we actually chose the front page as a static homepage rather than the post page. So it really does depend on what selection you have in your customizer, but for today, we're going to be using the front page as the first page of our site. As you can see, we've got the about page that we created earlier, but let's take a look at our front page because this one is actually pre-built from 2020 and it's got some content on it already. I'll click edit and it'll take me right to that front page. Welcome to our homepage as it exists now. If you remember back to when we built the About page, we used a lot of blocks to build the content of that page. As you can see here, all of these pieces that you're seeing are essentially blocks. Now, none of this content is anything that I actually built. This is all pre-built with a 2020 theme, but the first one we've got here is a heading block. We've got a couple of image blocks down here as well. Now, I don't really want any of this content here. I'm gonna change it up a little bit. So give me a moment. I'm gonna delete all of this content and then we're gonna build it from the ground up. And poof. All that content is gone, so now we can start building from the ground up. The first thing I'm going to tackle is the title. Now this will be the first text and content that your visitors will see, so I'm going to change this to something that's relevant for my site. I'll just highlight this text, paste in what I want. I'm going to put mine as Let's Get Started. I feel like I say that a lot. Now before we kick things off and actually start building the content of this site, I do want to let you know that this is the editor and you can have as much fun here as you want. There's so many blocks that you can use and so many different ways that you can design your website. I'm going to do mine in a very specific way, so I want to show you exactly how to put these blocks on and make them come together. But the creativity is all on you and have as much fun as you want to while you do this. Since we've already made my about page, I pull that up so we can have a little bit of inspiration for this front page. I always like to make sure that there's a little bit of continuity between the pages just so that the site flows better. Now remember here that I've got a separator block and then some text and some images, so we're going to take that same sort of inspiration into my front page. I'm going to head back now and I'm going to use my first block to add a separator. We'll click the plus and then click separator. And now I've got a very similar separator block that looks almost identical to my about page. And now I can start to build this page in a very similar way. Now I'm gonna add another block, but this time I wanna do a column. And we did a column on my about page, and I love them because they're so easy to break up content and make your site look really great. So I'm gonna choose column. Now before we actually choose what type of column we want, I wanna show you something cool about this here. We can click change alignment. What I'm gonna do is do full width, because as you can see right now, it's only taking up about half of my page. If I click full width, now it's gonna span across the entire length of my page. So now when I choose 50-50 for two columns, I've got one here and one here, which I think is gonna look really great. Now that I've got my column set, it's time to add some content. I'm gonna click the plus on the left-hand side to add a new block here, and I think I'd like to add a YouTube video. So I'm gonna type in YouTube, click on this type of block, and all I need to do right now is paste the URL to my video. I'll paste that here, I'll click embed. If you wanna know more about the process, you can click here as well. But I'll click embed, and now my video shows up on my page. Now I wanna do something on the right-hand side, so I'm gonna click the plus sign for add another block, and this time I wanna do a pull quote. So I'll click on that. I got some text over here that I'd like to put in. Paste that into the write quote section. And it's got an option for a citation down here, so I'm gonna put my name. Very cool. Now I can notice a little bit of differences here. I've got this awesome video block and I've got another pull quote block here, but it looks like there's some white space underneath it. So I'm gonna try and shore that up a little bit here. Now we can see I've got this block selected here, but in order to change this alignment, I actually need to make this adjustment to the column. So instead of selecting just this block, I'm gonna hover down here at the bottom and I'm gonna select the entire column. Now I'm making changes to both of the blocks inside the column and I'm actually gonna change the alignment. I'll click this option right here for change vertical alignment. As you can see, they're vertically aligned to the top, which is why there's a lot of white space down here at the bottom. I'm gonna click vertically align middle, and now it's all squared up. So I think that looks great for this block. Let's move on to the next one. The next thing I'm gonna do is scroll down just a little bit to add my next block. I'll click the plus sign here. I wanna keep a very similar formatting throughout this page, so I'm gonna add another separator block just like I have on the top. We'll click separator. It's already stretched all the way across the page, so I like that. Now I've got my title, separator block, my first columns of content, and then another separator block. Moving on down to the next block, I'm going to add a very similar one to the one we just added up here with the video and the pull quote, but this time I want to do a 50-50 split, but with just images. So I'll click the plus sign here. We're going to add another column block. And we're going to do 50-50 again, but this time let's make sure we do the change alignment and go full width. Now, very similar to the one we have up here, but this time I'm just going to add some pictures. So I'll click the plus add block here. And we're going to choose image, so you can search for this. Now I've got one inside of my media library, but as always, you can upload it here or you can insert it directly from a URL. So I'll click media library. I'm going to do a half split photo here. So I've got host on one side and Gator on the other. I'm going to click this one, click select. Here we go, scroll up just a little bit. I'm going to click plus to add another one, click image. I'm going to click media library, and I'm going to do the other side of this. Click select. So now we've got the same similar flow of content, two 50-50 blocks of the separator, and then an image that kind of blends together, which I think looks pretty nifty. All right, so I'm ready to move on to my next block, but before we do, I want to make sure that we save our changes. So let's go up here to the right-hand corner and click on update. You can see that it's starting to save the progress here. Now that it's saved on the bottom, you'll get an option to view the page. So let's go ahead and take a look and see what it looks like. As we can see, I've got my Let's Get Started title here, but I've actually got what looks to be an image or a remnant of the 2020 theme here. But if we scroll down, I can start to see the content is really taking shape. Let's go address how we can get rid of this featured image really quick. So we'll click on Edit Page. This takes me right back to where I was. So now what we're going to do is on the right-hand side, we're going to look for the page settings and we're going to click on Featured Image. Now the featured image is really important in the 2020 theme. Some themes will allow you to remove it, replace it. On this one, we can actually replace it or we can simply remove it. So I'm going to do the remove featured image section here. Click that and click update once more. And now let's go view the page and make sure that that's gone. Awesome, looks like it's been removed there. Now you can add any featured image that you want to if you'd like one at the top of your site. But for me, I wanted to have just let's get started and then the content for my site start to flow together. I think this looks great so far. Let's click on Edit Page and go back to where we were. So we'll scroll down to pick up where we left off. We had just added this two column block with two images. So now I'm going to start a new block down here. I'll click the plus sign and I'm going to add a paragraph block. Now I've got some text here that I want to add and I want to show you how to do a really awesome trick with the text to make it look a bit more interesting. So I'm going to paste my text here. On the right hand side, you can see we've got some block settings for this. We'll go into these a little bit more later, but I'm going to click the drop cap setting. As you can see, it takes the first letter of this paragraph and it makes it big and bold, kind of an old journalistic style. And I think that looks pretty awesome. Now that we've got this paragraph set, I want to show you a cool way to get to a new block in case you ever don't see the plus sign pop up. As you can see, it's kind of hard for me to click out of this block, and it's not giving me the option to add one directly below. Up here in the top left-hand corner, there's an add block setting. Click that, and it's going to take you to the full search bar for any block that WordPress has. I want to add a button here, so we'll use this. Click on button. Now you can see that new block has been added below. Now what I want to do here is give people the opportunity to actually link to our direct YouTube channel. So I'm going to paste in some content text for the button itself. Got that pasted in there. The next thing I want to do is click on the link option here, and I'm going to add a direct link to that URL. Paste that down there. Now it's always going to give you the option to open these in a new tab. I personally love doing that because it means that the visitor will go to the new site in a new tab and then come right back to my site. So I'm going to click that and then we'll click out, and now that block is ready and set. Now one thing I did note here is that it's justified to the left hand side, and I kind of want that in the center to go with the rest of my formatting. So I'm going to click on the block itself, click the change alignment, and then click align center. So now it's right in the center exactly where I want it. Now that I've shown you all the blocks that I'm going to use on my front page, I'm going to pause here for a second and build out the rest of my site. As soon as I come back, I'll show you what I did and we'll go over some of the block settings as well. All right, I'm back and I finished building out the rest of my homepage. So let's take a look at the new stuff that I added, but let's start from the top so we can go over everything that we've done so far. I've got my title here at the top, a two column block with a video embed from YouTube and a pull quote. Scrolling down a little bit further, I've got things separated by separator blocks, which I think really breaks up the space. The next section I've got here is a two column block with two images split 50-50. I've got a paragraph text, another separator block. This one has drop caps in it, which I really like. This is a new section that I just built out. It's actually a 6-column block, but with 6 different YouTube videos embedded. So basically the same thing we did with the 2-column block, just 6 different times so they have all the videos that I want to here. Scrolling down a little bit further, we've got a nice button here that leads directly to my YouTube channel. I also added another header block of text and another paragraph down here, along with another button that actually links directly to our Facebook group. Scrolling down a little bit further, I've got one large image at the bottom, and I think really rounds out my site. I went ahead and clicked update up here on the top right-hand corner to make sure everything is saved. Let's head over to my site and see exactly what it looks like. I think it looks pretty great so far, and we got that done in a very small amount of time. Now this is the fun part. You can take as much time as you want to build out your front of site. It could be something very simple and minimalistic, kind of like I did, or it can be extravagant and as big and beautiful as you want it to. Take all the time you want to here and build your site exactly the way that you want it. We'll head back to the edit page section. I want to show you one more thing about block settings. Now that we're back on the page editor, I want to show you a few things over here on the right-hand side. Let's first click on page settings. We can see that the options we have here are status and visibility. Now, visibility can be set to public, private, or password protected. If you want everyone in the world to see your site, public is a great way to go. You can also set it private for only your site admins or editors, and you can also password protect it if you really want to lock down the content that's on that page. I like public visibility, that's just fine for me. The next option you have here is to set it exactly when you want to publish. So say that I made this page, but I only want it to go live on a certain date. You can actually schedule that out here, choose the specific date, and then once you click update, it's not going to publish until that specific timeline. Moving down a little bit further, the permalink is always going to be your full URL. This is a setting that you can change in the WordPress settings, but it's a little bit more advanced of a feature. The feature image is something we already talked about. There was one that was default set by the 2020 theme. We're going to leave that as it is for now. You can also decide whether or not you want to allow comments on your page. This is very similar to a blog post where someone can tell you exactly what they think about your page right beneath it. So I'm going to leave this off for now because I always want people to engage with me on the comments, but not necessarily on the pages. Page attributes will also allow you to set default templates if you'd like. We're not going to cover that in this series, but let us know in the comments if you'd like to know more about that. The next thing I want to show you is the block settings. So let's go over here and click on block. As you can see, I've got no current block selected. So let's select one of the blocks that I have right here on my front page. I'm going to click on the pull quote block, and as you can see, a ton of options appear over here on the right-hand side. I can change different settings, default customizations about this specific block. They're all going to be located over here on the right-hand side between block settings, so just click through your blocks and see the different settings that you have for each one. As you can see here for the image one, I've got an option to make it rounded, change the style, alternative text, and a whole lot of other options. You can also change the width, height, dimensions, everything about the image down here as well. So I'd encourage you to scroll through, click on some of your blocks, and see if there's things that you want to customize or edit. And that just about covers getting your homepage built out. Make sure to tune into our next episode where we're going to cover the wonderful world of plugins. I hope you found this video helpful. As always, if you'd like to let us know what you think about the content we're making, please feel free to let us know in the comments below, and subscribe if you want to see more. Thanks, y'all.